Today we shall be discussing the superiority of Keynesian theory over the traditional quantity theory of money. It is considered that Keynes' theory of money and prices is superior to the traditional quantity theory of money. There are certain reasons in this support, and let us discuss them one by one. The first point says that Keynes opposes the old view that relationship between quantity of money and prices is direct and proportional. As we saw in the traditional approach, that they say that the quantity of money and prices, the relation is direct and proportional. As and when one rises, the other will also rise. And in what manner? In the proportional manner. But on the contrary, Keynes establishes an indirect and non-proportional relationship between these two items. Mane, quantity of money and prices, according to Keynes, they have an indirect and non-proportional relationship. This is the first point to which we say that Keynes' theory is superior to the traditional approach. Second point comes forward that Keynes integrated the monetary theory with the value theory. He integrates monetary theory with the value theory and with the theory of output and employment. He has integrated these two theories through the rate of interest. What has he taken? Rate of interest. Rate of interest plays a very important role. See, as the quantity of money increases, the rate of interest falls. Now, when the rate of interest falls, the volume of investment and aggregate demand tends to rise. Thereby, there is a rise in output and employment. Now, with the rate of interest, considering it as the main factor, Keynes states that when quantity of money rises, the volume of investment and aggregate demand also rises, because when the money increases, rate of interest will fall. So ultimately what happens is that output and employment will also rise. When this output and employment increase, they further raise the demand for the factors of production. So rise in the quantity of money leads to rise in the demand for factors of production. Now, when this rises, certain bottlenecks appear which raise the marginal cost, including the money wage rates. In this whole process, what happens is marginal cost will increase. Therefore, the prices start rising. In this way, monetary theory is integrated with the value theory, and we started from the rise in the quantity of money and we reached till when the prices start rising. Hence, we conclude that Keynes' theory is superior to the traditional approach. Further, third point comes, Keynes discard the unrealistic assumption of full employment of resources. Now, the whole traditional theory is based on the assumption of full employment of resources, which is totally discarded and opposed by Keynes. Keynes believed that full employment of resources is an exception. As long as there is unemployment, output and employment will change in the same proportion as the quantity of money, but there will be no rise in the prices. So he considers that till the time we are facing unemployment, and when during that unemployment, output and employment, they will rise in the same proportion as the quantity of money. When the quantity of money will rise, output will rise and employment will rise, but there is only one condition, that there should be unemployment. And when this whole process will continue, there will be no rise in the prices. Prices will not rise because there is unemployment. Further, he says the second part, the B part, is when there is full employment, then the prices will change in the same proportion as the quantity of money. So we are considering two aspects. One is there is unemployment, and then when there is full employment. When there is unemployment, prices will not rise. And when there is full employment, prices will change in the same proportion as the quantity of money. Hence, Keynes' theory is superior as it studies the relationship between the quantity of money and prices, both under employment and for full employment. So Keynes' theory is, why is it considered superior? Because we are studying this quantity theory of money with two subheadings. When there is underemployment, unemployment is there, and when full employment is there. Therefore, we come to the conclusion that Keynes' theory is again superior to the traditional approach. Now, the fourth point. Keynes emphasizes on the important policy implications. In this theory, we come to know that the approach has this positivity of emphasizing the objective of full employment and price stability. We consider, Keynes has considered these two points also. See, Keynes believed that as long as there is unemployment, the rise in prices is gradual and there is no danger of inflation. Actually, unemployment, when there is unemployment, the prices are not rising. Output will rise, but prices will not rise. Once full employment is reached, rises in prices inflationary. Now the prices will start rising and inflation will crop in with every increase in the quantity of money. So the danger of inflation will come only when full employment is reached. Till the time there is unemployment, there is no danger of inflation. Prices will not rise. Thus, this approach has the virtue of emphasizing that the objective of full employment and price stability may be inherently irreconcilable. Right? So, again, the fourth point symbolizes that Keynes' theory is superior to the traditional approach. Here we come to the end of the article. Please like and subscribe to my channels. If you have any suggestions, please feel free to comment in the comment box. What all other videos you would like to see, please feel free to comment for that also. Thank you for watching. Stay safe, stay blessed.